बचेंगे, कानून से प्रधानमंत्री भी नहीं बचेंगे, देश के संविधान के अंडर टेकिंग आते हैं वो भी। आरएसएस के लोगों ने प्लान करके, मेरे पास तो रिकॉर्डिंग है, बकायदा मैं दूंगा सुप्रीम कोर्ट में, मुझे तो धमकियां दी जा रही थी, यहां मत आना चंद्र तुम्हारा कत्ल कर देंगे। मुल्क टूट रहा है, जो घर बैठेगा वो गद्दार होगा। हम लोग घर नहीं बैठेंगे, हम अपने मुल्क के साथ खड़े हैं। और यहाँ पे हजूम देखिए, ये आप हजूम देखिए, ये समय रात के 11 बज रहे हैं, चारों तरफ बैरिकेडिंग करके रोका जा रहा है। जामिया के बच्चे आ रहे हैं, जेएनयू के बच्चे आ रहे हैं, डीयू के बच्चे आ रहे हैं, एएमयू के बच्चे आ रहे हैं, चारों तरफ बैरिकेडिंग करके रोका जा रहा है। लेकिन यहाँ के लोकल लोग ही बैठे हुए, ये खुशी से नहीं बैठे, इनको तकलीफ हो रही है। धर्म के नाम पर बंटवारा नहीं चलेगा, कोई नहीं कर पाएगा। ये वही सीढ़ियां जहां मौलाना आजाद साहब ने स्टेटमेंट दिया था कि देश को बटने नहीं देंगे। आर्टिकल 14 और आर्टिकल 15 धर्म के आधार पर भेदभाव का बिल्कुल कड़ा विरोध करता है, उसको खत्म किया जा रहा है। बाबा साहब का बच्चा हूं, बाबा साहब का बेटा हूं, अपने होते संविधान को खत्म होने नहीं दूंगा। हमने पुलिस से अपील की है, 6 बसें हमारे सामने भर के ले गए यहाँ से बच्चों की, छोटे छोटे उनकी माताएं, उनकी बहनें मुझसे पूछ रही, मेरी बहनें, मेरी माताएं कि चंद्रशेखर तुम्हारे भरोसे भेजे थे, बच्चे कहाँ हैं? मैंने कहा आप उनको वापस भेज दीजिए, फिर हम प्रशासन से वार्ता करेंगे। प्रशासन के लोग कह रहे हैं कि आप चंद्रशेखर आप चले जाओ, आपको छोड़ देंगे। हम कह रहे हैं हमें अरेस्ट करो, जेल भेजो। अगर हमने गुनाह किया है, कानून तोड़ा है, कानून हाथ में लिया, तो हमें जेल भेज दो। लेकिन जब हम कानून के साथ खड़े, किस आधार पर भेजोगे जेल? मैं गिरफ्तार देने को तैयार हूँ, बिल्कुल तैयार हूँ, गिरफ्तारी दें, मुझे फांसी चढ़ा दें। लेकिन देश को तोड़ने वाले बिल का समर्थन ना आज होगा ना भविष्य में होगा। जो कानून बन चुका है, हम लोग संसद में नहीं थे तो वहाँ नहीं रोक पाए, यहाँ रोकेंगे सड़क पे। ये हमारा डेमोक्रेटिक राइट है, कॉन्स्टिट्यूशनल राइट है, फंडामेंटल राइट है। जो भी कुछ गलत हो आप उसके सहमत रहें, उसका विरोध करें, लोकतांत्रिक तरीके से, संविधान तरीके से हम लोग कर रहे हैं। मैं, प्राचा जी, हमारे और साथी बहादुर भाई, गुलजार भाई, नईम भाई, सब लोग यहाँ हैं। और सिर्फ एक जो चेहरा बनाया जा रहा था कि सब मुसलमान है सड़क पे, मुसलमान नहीं है, ये दलित का बेटा खड़ा है, मैं दूंगा पहले शहादत। मुल्क को टूटने की याद किसी को नहीं दे, जो तोड़ना चाहते हैं उनको बताना चाहते हैं। मेरे साथ यहाँ हजारों लोग आए थे, ओबीसी भाई, दलित भाई, हम सब लोग यहाँ, और सबसे ऊपर इसलिए बैठे, जैसा उस दिन बताया था जामिया पे, गोली पहले हमें लगनी चाहिए। लेकिन हमारे हाथ ऐसे बंधे हुए थे, आप देखिए, दिखाइएगा आप लोगों को, ये हाथ ऐसे बंधे रहेंगे। लेकिन
सभी जितने प्रोटेस्टर,
सब प्रोटेस्टर के हाथ ऐसे ही बंधे हुए, लाठियां भी खा रहे हैं, हमें खून भी चल रहा है हम लोगों के, हम बच्चों के लोगों से, हमारे जो बच्चे यहाँ उफ नहीं कर रहे हैं, क्योंकि लड़ाई अपनी जान की कीमत की नहीं है, लड़ाई है मुल्क को बचाने की। धर्म के नाम पर बंटवारा कोई नेता नहीं मरेगा बहन, मरेंगे आम आदमी, अपने लोगों के लिए हम लोग यहाँ
Well, that of course was Chandrashekhar Azad. Remember the Bhim Sena chief who was at Jama Masjid earlier today, where there was a lot of drama and high action during the protests. Well, day 6 of the Anti-Citizenship Amendment Act protests today. Protests continued across India in several cities, despite attempts to clamp down on them. Today as well, protests turned violent in some parts of the country, specifically Uttar Pradesh and the national capital as well, with the police resorting to water cannons and lathi charge. In fact, at least 5 people have lost their lives in the violent clashes in Uttar Pradesh. Meanwhile, amidst all the protests against the Citizenship Act, there was one pro-Citizenship Act rally that was held by BJP workers in Chennai. Let's in fact start with focusing on what happened in the national capital today. Several protesters were stopped at Delhi Gate while they were on a protest march towards India Gate. After the march was halted midway, things turned violent with protesters pelting stones at police personnel. A car was also torched by protesters. In an attempt to bring the crowd under control, the police then were forced to use water cannons to disperse the protesters. Here's a ground report from Ayushman while all of this was going on earlier this evening.
ये बैरिकेडिंग के उस साइड थे ये प्रदर्शनकारी जिन्होंने आगजनी की है। हम कोशिश करेंगे कि आपको ताजा विजुअल्स ला कर दें। ये देखिए, आप देख सकते हैं यहाँ पर आगजनी हुई है। ये आप देखिए, यहाँ पर आग को बुझाने की कोशिश है। आप देख सकते हैं यहाँ पे आग को बुझाने की कोशिश की जा, आप देख सकते हैं पुरजोर कोशिश हो रही है। देखिए, आप देखिए दिल्ली पुलिस की तरफ से कोशिश की जा रही है कि ये जो कार जल रही है, यहाँ पे वो गाड़ी है जो अभी जल रही है, और पुलिस ने कहा है जो भी लोग यहाँ पर मौजूद हैं उनको गाड़ी से पीछे हटने को कहा है, क्योंकि वो आग को बुझाने में काबू नहीं पा पाए, और इसके कारण आप देख सकते हैं कि जो कार है वो जल रही है। यहाँ पर कोशिश ये है कि वाटर कैनन वाली गाड़ी को लाकर यहाँ पर आग को बुझाया जाए, कोशिश यही है। इसलिए अगर आप देखें इसमें जो गाड़ी के अंदर जो आग लग रही है उसे बुझाने का प्रयास अभी भी दिल्ली पुलिस करेगी ज़रूर, और इसके लिए वो वाटर कैनन की गाड़ी दूसरी तरफ से लाई जा रही है। अगर आप बात करें यहाँ पर प्रदर्शनकारी जमा थे, आप देख सकते हैं वो कार है जिससे आप देख सकते हैं वाटर कैनन का इस्तेमाल किया जा रहा है। ये विजुअल्स हैं जिसमें दिल्ली पुलिस की जो गाड़ी है वो कोशिश कर रही है कि कैसे आग पर काबू पाया जाए गाड़ी के। ये दिल्ली डिप्यूटी कमिश्नर ऑफ पुलिस का ऑफिस है जहां पर ये गाड़ी जलाई गई है। गाड़ी के अंदर से वो आवाज़ें आ रही थी, इसीलिए दिल्ली पुलिस ने कहा कि कोई एक्सप्लोजन हो सकता है, इसलिए मीडियाकर्मी कृपया पीछे जाएं। आप देख सकते हैं वाटर कैनन का तेज पानी की धार भी जो आग को है कितनी देर लग रही है काबू पाने में इस आग पर। ये डिप्यूटी कमिश्नर ऑफ पुलिस जो हैं उनका ऑफिस है मंदार, उसके सामने ये कार को आग लगाया गया, कार में आग लगाई गई, जिसके बाद अब दिल्ली पुलिस कोशिश कर रही है कि कैसे इस आग पर काबू पाया जाए। मौजूदा हालात आपको यहां पर दिख जाएंगे। जब प्रदर्शनकारी यहां पर बैठे थे पहले कोशिश थी कि कैसे वाटर कैनन से हटाया जाए, प्रदर्शनकारी यहीं पर थे, यहीं से पथराव किया जा रहा था। दूसरी तरफ जब वाटर कैनन का इस्तेमाल हुआ उसी बीच हमने ये देखा कि एक जो गाड़ी थी उसे जला दिया गया। यहाँ पर ये गाड़ी के अंदर से वो एक्सप्लोजन हुआ है, और इसीलिए शायद दिल्ली पुलिस ने कहा था कि गाड़ी से उचित दूरी बनाकर रखनी होगी। भी आपको अगर दिखाएं तो सड़क जो दूसरी तरफ है वो सड़क पूरी ही तरह से खाली है। अब जो पुलिस के अधिकारी हैं, जो रैपिड एक्शन फोर्स की टीम है, अब वो बैरिकेड के इस तरफ आ चुकी हैं। अगर अभी भी आप देखें तो वाटर कैनन का इस्तेमाल जो है वो बंद कर दिया गया है, मगर जो गाड़ी है उस पर अभी आप उसमें देख सकती हैं कि कहीं ना कहीं जो आग है वो दिख रही है आपको। प्रदर्शनकारी तो हट गए हैं लेकिन उनके द्वारा जो नुकसान यहाँ पर किया गया है वो कहीं नहीं हट पा रहा, और दिल्ली पुलिस को यहाँ पर काबू करने में इस पे परेशानी आ रही है।
Breaking news that's coming in. These are videos on your screens of Delhi cops thrashing locals near Delhi Gate, which have emerged. These videos were shot today by local residents. You can see on your screens Delhi cops picking up locals. They're actually beating them up. Remember, this evening, violent crowd had set a car ablaze in Daryaganj area while a protest march was taken out from Jama Masjid to Jantar Mantar. Now, these videos clearly show how Delhi police used force in an attempt to disperse the crowd. Remember, also water cannons were also used in an attempt to disperse the crowds. And these videos now emerging of what happened earlier this evening. Meanwhile, after all of this, the Delhi police made a statement about these clashes that happened today, saying that they were forced to use water cannons because protesters started pelting stones. They also said that some of the policemen were injured and protesters have been detained as well. Listen in.
6:30 बजे ये कुछ हमारे जो हैं लोग जो इकट्ठे हुए थे, इनमें से कुछ आउटसाइडर्स भी आए, इन्होंने स्टोन पेल्टिंग वगैरह शुरू की और हमने वाटर कैनन यूज़ किया, टीयर गैस वगैरह कुछ यूज़ करने की ज़रूरत नहीं पड़ी, और बाद में हम लोग को पीछे पुश कर दिया और इसमें हमारे कुछ पुलिस पर्सनल को इंजरी आई है और इनके भी काफ़ी लोग हमने डिटेन किया।
नंबर्स हैं कि कितने?
अभी नंबर्स हम आपसे शेयर
कर, कितने हुए सर?
अभी शेयर कर।
प्रोटेस्ट चल रहा था लेकिन बिल्कुल चेंज हो गया, अग्रेसिव प्रोटेस्ट हो गया।
वही मैं कह रहा हूँ कि इनके पीसफुल था लेकिन कुछ अभी हम इन्वेस्टिगेशन कर रहे हैं, उसके बाद ही पता लगेगा।
Meanwhile, earlier on today as well, there was high drama near Jama Masjid in Old Delhi. Bhim Sena Chief Chandrashekhar Azad, who you just heard a couple of minutes back, was there to lead the protests from Jama Masjid to Jantar Mantar. The police then tried to detain Chandrashekhar Azad, but were unable to do so after the crowd started shouting slogans against the police. Take a look at some of the reactions and a ground report from Jama Masjid earlier today.
हमारे देश के संविधान आर्टिकल 15 को बदल के जो सरकार अपना संविधान लागू कर रही है, अब आप एक बात बताइए, 70 साल पुराना 50 साल पुराना प्रूफ हम कहां से दें? कैसे पता करोगे आपके इंडियन है?
प्यार बांटो देश नहीं।
सरकार ये कहती है, कल भी सरकार ने कहा कि सीएए के बाद
नहीं, लिखत के अंदर दे दें, लिखत के अंदर दे दें, वोट्स नहीं लिखत के अंदर।
पूरा हिंदुस्तान बड़ा भाई खिलाफ है, क्यों नहीं हो रहे वापसी है? चलो एक आदमी हो, दो आदमी, नौ आदमी है, पूरा हिंदुस्तान खिलाफ है भाई।
सर मेरा कहना ये है कि उन्होंने एनआरसी और कैप को निकालने के बाद ये पक्का जाहिर कर दिया कि अपना बेटा यतीम कर दिया और दूसरा बेटा गोदी ले लिया।
चंद्रशेखर आजाद अमंगस्ट द क्राउड दैट इज देयर, यू कैन क्लियरली सी चंद्रशेखर आजाद बीइंग डिटेन्ड बाय द पुलिस ऑफिशियल्स। देयर यू सी द पीआरओ ऑफ दिल्ली पुलिस विद चंद्रशेखर आजाद। द ह्यूज क्राउड हैज गैदर्ड एट द outside of Jama Masjid after the Friday prayers. This is the situation outside Jama Masjid. Chandrashekhar Azad hasn't been given the permission to carry out a march from Jama Masjid to Jantar Mantar, and the police officials have already clarified that he will be detained the moment he comes out of the Jama Masjid, and he has come out of the Jama Masjid now. You can see in the visuals, police official detaining Chandrashekhar Azad who is of the Bhim army, who had given a call for the march from here to Jantar Mantar. This is the situation of Jama Masjid on Friday. This is after prayers. People have gathered in large number protesting against the Citizenship Amendment Act. Chandrashekhar Azad holding the Constitution of India and Baba Bhim Rao Ambedkar's photo has been detained by the police officials.
Meanwhile, in light of all the protests, Congress Chief Sonia Gandhi extended her solidarity to students who are protesting across the country, also slamming the center for using brute force and spreading tensions across the country with the citizenship law and the proposed NRC.
The BJP government has shown utter disregard for people's voices and chosen to use brute force to suppress dissent. This is unacceptable in a democracy. The Congress Party condemns the actions of the BJP government and expresses its solidarity with the students and citizens of India in their just struggle. The Citizenship Amendment Act is discriminatory, and the proposed nationwide NRC will particularly hurt the poor and vulnerable.
Let's now shift focus to Uttar Pradesh, where five people have lost their lives in the violent clashes today. Of the five casualties, two have been reported from Bijnor and one each from Firozabad, Sambal and Meerut. The situation remained tense in several parts of Uttar Pradesh, with violence spreading to several parts as well. A clash broke out in Gorakhpur, where protesters were seen pelting stones at the police. A similar protest erupted in Ghaziabad, Meerut, where police resorted to lathi charge. Meanwhile, protesters pelted stones at security personnel in Firozabad and Badohi. Protesters were lathi charged as well in Barech, while vehicles were vandalized in Bulandshahr. Meanwhile, internet services remain suspended in 22 major cities and Section 144 remains in place.
Jama Masjid aur baki aas paas ki masjidon se jab namaz chuti hai to kuch ladke jahan jama hue jinhone police party par patharao kiya, aap dekh sakte hain police ne thoda sa bal prayog kiya hai aur titar bitar kar diya gaya. Filhal sthiti bilkul niyantran mein hai, ekdam halat niyantran mein, koi dikkat nahi hai.
In Meerut specifically, protesters resorted to violence and even burnt vehicles. They also targeted a police outpost and tried to set it ablaze, but was dispersed by the cops, who rushed to the spot on time. Some policemen and civilians were also injured in this incident.
शाम के समय में भारी संख्या में कुछ उपद्रवी लोग सड़कों पर आए थे, जिनके द्वारा पथराव किया गया, उनके द्वारा फायरिंग भी तमंचों से की गई, और इसमें पुलिस द्वारा जो कार्रवाई की गई उसमें करीब डेढ़ दर्जन लोगों को हिरासत में लिया गया है. इसके अलावा और भी लोग चिन्हित किए गए हैं जिनके खिलाफ कार्रवाई सुनिश्चित की जा रही है. इनके द्वारा जो पथराव हुआ है उसमें करीब आधा दर्जन पुलिसकर्मी थे जिनको हल्की चोटें आई हैं, और हमारे आरएएफ के दो जवान थे जिनको छर्रे लगे थे, सबका इलाज करा दिया गया है, सब लोग ठीक हैं, और डेढ़ दर्जन लोग गिरफ्तार हुए हैं. इसके अतिरिक्त ये भी सूचना मिली है है कि जो दंगाई थे इन्होंने फायरिंग जो की है उसमें आपस में भी इनके किसी व्यक्ति को गोली लगी है, उसको भी हम लोग सुनिश्चित कर रहे हैं कि किस व्यक्ति को गोली लगी है उसको सत्यापित करने का हम लोग प्रयास कर रहे हैं। आगजनी ये एक चौकी के पास, इस्लामाबाद चौकी के पास आए थे, जब फोर्स ने इनको भगाया तो भागते समय इन्होंने एक बाइक सड़क के किनारे जलाई है, फायर टेंडर आ गया, उसकी आग तत्काल बुझा ली गई थी और वो भी सारे लोग चिन्हित कर लिए गए थे, उन पर भी कार्रवाई सुनिश्चित की जा रही है। बाकी किसी चौकी किसी थाने में किसी प्रकार की कोई आगजनी नहीं है और स्थिति जनपद में पूरी तरह से सामान्य है।
I personally have not seen something like that happening in Lucknow for the past many years. But despite that, despite a high-level meeting that was shared at the residence of Chief Minister Yogi Adityanath late at night, despite the fact that Section 144 was in place, many thought that today things would be relatively calmer. But you know, surprisingly and shockingly, things went bizarre even today in districts like Pilibhit, Baghpat, Gorakhpur, Yogi's home turf, and Kanpur and Firozabad, where we can confirm to our viewers right now that at least 5 people have been confirmed are dead in the protests that erupted in various parts of the states. And protesters did come out on streets in large numbers. Despite the fact that Section 144 was in place, the people were allowed to assemble. How did it happen? One doesn't know. It's a matter of investigation. But that is the reality. People did assemble. And as a result of which, we saw widespread violence across the state of Uttar Pradesh, especially in Western Uttar Pradesh, where even now, as I speak to you, I am getting information of violence actually being reported from the districts of Meerut and connecting Hapur. So clearly, Western UP is not peaceful at all. And that's the reason of a worry for the UP government. But will the UP government, that was absolutely on toes when the Ayodhya verdict was delivered, nothing had happened. How is it possible that the UP police did not have any idea about the kind of protest, the magnitude of protest that was lying under the wraps in the state of Uttar Pradesh? So many questions are being asked of the UP government. How soon does the answer come? And how soon will the investigation actually finish? Is something only the time will tell. But for now, people in the state of Uttar Pradesh, the government is only urging people to maintain calm and maintain restraint.
Meanwhile, protests were also staged in Mumbai at Crawford Market and in Kurla areas, protesters demanding the rollback of the Citizenship Act.
कि ये ऐसे ही सीए के एक तरफ सारे नॉन मुस्लिम्स को इन लोग सिटीजनशिप देंगे और एक तरफ मुसलमानों को सिटीजनशिप नहीं देंगे। अब मुसलमान बेचारा गरीब तबके का, इसमें हिंदू मुसलमान सारे लोग आते हैं, जो गरीब तबके के लोग हैं वो कहाँ से साबित करेंगे हम हिंदुस्तानी, और हम ही को बोला जा रहा है कि आप हिंदुस्तानी साबित करो, ये कहाँ का कानून है? जब अपने पास पहले से सारे डॉक्यूमेंट्स हैं तो ये एनआरसी लाने की जरूरत नहीं है। इसके पीछे हजारों करोड़ जो खर्चा होगा, मेन मुद्दा तो वो कहाँ से आएगा? पहले सरकार इसका तो कुछ बताए कि भाई ये हम कहाँ से लाएंगे।
हम लोग किसी ऑर्गेनाइजेशन से नहीं है, सारे मुसलमान भाई जितने भी हमारे हिंदू मुस्लिम भाई हैं, जो भी सीएबी के खिलाफ है, एनआरसी के खिलाफ है, वो सब लोग घर से बाहर निकले हैं। वो ये जताना चाहते हैं कि यह सरकार हिंदुस्तान के अंदर एक सेकुलर गवर्नमेंट होनी चाहिए और गवर्नमेंट की सोच भी हमेशा जो है सेकुलर होना चाहिए, संविधान के अनुसार होना चाहिए।
हमारे गृह मंत्री साहब ने कहा कि इससे एक धर्म विशेष को बाहर रखा जाएगा। अब आप इस प्रक्रिया को जब एनआरसी से जोड़ेंगे तब आप देखेंगे इसका दुष्परिणाम क्या होगा, तो आप ये बेहतर जानते हैं। तो इसलिए हमारा ये जो विरोध है, ये आपके चैनल के माध्यम से हम ये कह देना चाह रहे हैं कि जब तक सरकार इस बिल पर पुनर्विचार नहीं करेगी, ये आंदोलन इसी प्रकार से जारी रहेगा।
ये पूरी साजिश चली है केंद्र सरकार की, हम लोग इसका पूर्ण विरोध कर रहे हैं और चाहते हैं केंद्र सरकार के वापस ले ये कानून।
In Kurla, protesters took to the streets and protested against the Citizenship Amendment Act as well as the NRC. Protesters held placards peacefully protesting amidst tight police security.
If we can show you around, the protesters are there present in huge numbers. The exact area where I'm standing right now is next to Shalimar Hotel. This is in Kurla area. This comes in the central suburbs of Mumbai. And if my video journalist Anil Shinde can show you the kind of presence this mass gathering has collected today in the Kurla area. There are around 1,000 to 2,000 people present in this particular spot. I can quickly show you with the flags in their hand and also at the same time banners saying their objection or raising their objections against the CAA, that is the Citizenship Act, that they are here to express their protest against this. Remember, this comes only a day after when we saw a massive gathering at Congress Kranti Maidan in Mumbai yesterday. Up to 10,000 people had gathered there. And the protest here continues. This is Kurla area which we are talking about. One of the essential central suburbs locality of Mumbai where you can see the protest here, the movement here, actually the mass gathering here from people has begun.
And in the midst of all the protests opposing the Citizenship Amendment Act across the country, in Chennai today, there was a rally that was held in favor of the act, which of course was called for by the BJP workers. Meanwhile, shops were shut and security was stepped up in Coimbatore.
Right now, the same place where actually there was a protest yesterday that was led by various civil societies, and today this is BJP that is holding the protest at this area, and BJP's leader H. Raja, national secretary, is the one who is actually going to lead the protest here. And you could see the crowd. This is the crowd that is assembled at the spot, and this is the crowd that is supporting CAA and NRC, and that's the reason they are over here. And the organization also claims that they are protesting against DMK and Congress, which according to them is providing false information about CAA and NRC, and that's the reason they are protesting at this spot. This is Vallur Kottam, the very exact spot there, like, you know, where the protest occurred yesterday, by various others against NRC and CAA. Sir, in the protest, why are you, like, participating in this protest? What is the reason?
There have been protests against CAA everywhere. There are also a group of people who want to support CAA. So this is the crowd that supports the act.
That's the reason you're here now?
Yes, of course.
And like, what about DMK and Congress? It is also being said that the protests against them because, according to the BJP, they are providing fake information. Is that so?
Because we believe they are misleading the Muslims, saying that it is against their religion. So that is what we want to clear the act, that it is not against any religion in India.
So CAA and NRC is not against Muslims?
Certainly not.
Any reason why like the Muslims are being like not included in CAA then?
I think they are misled by opposition parties and other parties. That is the only reason. Even the Shahi Imam of the Delhi Jama Masjid has given out a statement saying it is not against Indian Muslims.
Not against Indian Muslims. That's the reason, there's so much of the protest at right this location, Vallur Kottam, and as you could see, this is a group that's from BJP. They are BJP volunteers who are at this spot right now protesting for CAA and NRC.
Meanwhile, Kerala witnessed a series of protests as well. In Malappuram, students were seen staging a protest march. Meanwhile, in Thiruvananthapuram, Kerala Union of Working Journalists demanded that the new law be scrapped. Turning our attention to Karnataka now, where remember Section 144 is in place until tomorrow. In Bengaluru, hundreds of students staged an indefinite protest at the Bengaluru Central University. They demanded that the Karnataka government should withdraw police deployment across college and universities in the state. Meanwhile, the Karnataka High Court also pulled up the state government for imposing prohibitory orders, asking if the state was going to ban every protest that takes place in the state on the assumption that it could turn violent.
Well, several students have in fact gathered here at the Central College grounds in Bengaluru to stage their protest and voice their concern against the CAA and the NRC as well. What you're seeing is in fact at this point in time students who actually have just risen up in protest, and this is despite Section 144 actually being imposed here in Karnataka, in Bengaluru as well. Let's actually talk to one of the protesters and find out what their demands really are, because these are going to continue. So first of all, I want to ask you, a lot of students have come out to protest over here today. What are your main demands?
Main demand is to remove all police deployment from every educational institution in this country. Universities, schools, colleges are temples to students. If faith is respected in this country, you need to respect the faith of the students, of the teachers, of the educators. This is not how a democracy works. This is not how we will make our country run.
They don't serve, we are not there to serve, because
this is our fundamental right to stand for others who can't, and in these grey situations we will stand by Jamia.
We are against NRCCA, and students who have gathered here are united. We will fight against NRC. I hope all here, most of them are not coming on based on the religions. They come as the humans and they'll fight against India. And I ask to save Mangalore. As you all know what has happened in Mangalore yesterday, we condemn it, and every student here condemn the attack in Mangalore.
So, you know, we will actually have to wait and see till how long students will continue their protest. As yes, despite Section 144 being imposed, they seem not to be deterred at all, and the protests in fact are going to continue, is what they've maintained. With video journalist Sunil, this is Neha Hebale for Mirror Now in Bengaluru.
Meanwhile, 8 Kerala-based journalists who had interviewed relatives of the two people who were killed in Bengaluru on December 19th during the anti-citizenship protests were released 7 hours after being detained by the Bengaluru police. The journalists were first prevented from reporting, kept in a van for 3 hours and then taken to Bengaluru South Police Station. Their cameras and cell phones were also seized. Time Network's Imran Khan spoke to the relative of one of the injured protesters in Bengaluru, who recalls what happened inside the hospital when cops barged in.
This is a hospital where one of the person who was shot by the police is undergoing treatment at the intensive care unit. Now, last night we saw that police barging in and throwing tear gas shells in the ICU unit. And what was surprising is the fact that the cops entered the hospital and damaged the properties and also threw tear gas shells in the intensive care unit, baffling many and also questioning the role of the police here. Let me go across to the person, the family members, and to understand what led to the attack of the police and what was the rationale they gave. तो ये बताइए पहले कि उमरान क्या कर रहे थे कल और क्यों उनको गोली लगी?
वो काम से आया था, काम से आया था, उधर गाड़ी रख के थोड़ा इधर आया था, वो लोग गोली मारा है।
गोली मारा है? हाँ। ये गोली किसने मारा? पुलिस ने मारा?
पुलिस सिविल ड्रेस का है और पुलिस भी, दोनों भी है।
दोनों भी था। तो रात में ये बताइए पुलिस आई क्यों और क्यों यहाँ पे ये किया?
वो स्टेटमेंट लेने के लिए आया था।
स्टेटमेंट लेने के लिए। तो फिर यहाँ पे टियर गैस शेल और थोड़ा फोड़ा पुलिस ने क्यों किया?
वो लोग उधर झगड़ा हुआ, वो लोग अंदर आए, फुल उधर मार के पूरा आदमी लोग को मारा है इधर।
किस किस को मारा?
मारा है, हम मालूम नहीं कितना आदमी को मारा है, ज्यादा आदमी को मारा है।
Minister of State for Railways defended the police action in Bengaluru while answering a journalist's question. He defended it saying, and I quote, "If someone comes to your house and burns it, will you keep quiet?" End of quote. He also went on to ask whether a revolver has been kept for puja. This comment comes after two people died in Bengaluru yesterday during the protests, which turned violent and resulted in police firing.
ನಿಮ್ಮ ಮನೆಗೆ ಯಾರ ಬೆಂಕಿ ಹಚ್ಚಕ್ ಬರ್ತಾರ ಸುಮ್ಮನೆ ಕುಂಡಿರ್ತೀರಿ? ಅಲ್ಲ ನಾನು ಹೇಳ್ರಿ, ನೀವು ನಿಮ್ಮ ಮನೆಗೆ ಬೆಂಕಿ ಹಚ್ಚಕ್ ಬರ್ತಾರ ಯಾರ? ನಿಮ್ಮ ಮನೆಗೆ ಹೆಣ್ಮಕ್ಳು ಅದಾರ, ನಿಮ್ಮ ಮಕ್ಳು ಅದಾರ, ಕಲ್ಲು ಯಾಕೆ ಬರ್ತಾರ? ಅವಾಗ ಏನ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೀರಿ? ನಿಮ್ ಕಡೆ ರಿವಾಲ್ವರ್ ಅದ, ಅವ್ನು ಪೂಜೆ ಮಾಡ್ತಾರೆ ರಿವಾಲ್ವರ್ ಇಟ್ಕೊಂಡ?
And Karnataka Home Minister Basavaraj Bommai has regretted the action that was taken against historian Ramchandra Guha. Remember, the historian was dragged by cops and detained while he was protesting against the Citizenship Act in Bengaluru.
Police action, which has been meted out especially to the protesters, is... What do you think about it?
Madam, the entire crowd was instigated, including the neighboring Kerala. A lot of people had come to do the violence. They had taken law into their hand. There was a heavy stone pelting, and there was burning of the vehicles, and all the stone pelting was done on the police, and huge losses to the public properties. So we have to protect it.
Is there a protocol when or not to open fire?
Sir? Yeah, it's all those things are there, certainly. And all our senior officers have done their duty.
So, but we also hear from the protesters that, you know, you cannot, especially, it's a fundamental right of a person to protest. So why is the state government...
We are not questioning their protest. We are questioning the violence in the protest.
But why
is creating violence a fundamental right? I'm asking you.
No, so why can't they sit and protest?
Is creating violence, stone pelting, burning is a fundamental right?
Why can't they sit
and protest? That is why when there was a peace protest in Bangalore and Gulbarga, there was no lathi charge, no firing. Here there was a stone pelting, burning, and they wanted to burn a police station. That's why the action has been taken.
So this happened after the section 144 came into place. So why did the section 144
come? Madam, you should read your books, do your homework properly. 144 is a preventive measure, and that preventive has to be done before the incident, not after the incident.
So, but we also hear that the police, in fact, went forward and then opened fire.
Thank you. Now, what you said?
So I said the police went ahead and then opened fire to ensure that the protesters leave the place, the location.
Ma'am, how many times to repeat? The police station was garroted by these notorious people. They were trying to burn the police station. 15 policemen were inside. They would have been burnt alive. To prevent that, as a last resort, it was done. Ramchandra Guha.
Oh, yes.
Yesterday, he was detained for a few hours. I express my regret over that. He's a great historian. He's a good friend right from my father's time. I regret his small hours of detention. And I seek his advice. He's a great source of knowledge. If there is anything to be amended in this law, anything improvement has to be done. If he can come out with the ideas, I'll only make arrangement with the Honorable Home Minister of Government of India, and let's have a discussion, debate, and our Honorable Home Minister has already said that if there are any amendment to be done, he is ready for it, he's open for it.
Okay.
So I request Ramchandra Guha, please come advise us, and we'll take his advice very seriously.
Okay, sir. The state government is apologizing to Ramchandra Guha.
I express my regret.
Finance Minister Nirmala Sitharaman has reacted to this ongoing confusion over the NRC and Citizenship Act. She said that the NRC process would not begin without consulting stakeholders or without talking to people. She also slammed the opposition and said that some parties are linking the Citizenship Act to the NRC, which hasn't even started.
Nothing to do actually with any Indian citizen who's already a citizen. In particular, it doesn't question anybody's citizenship at all. I think we should first get that clear. And also, it is not going to be of any difficulty for anybody. There is just no relationship in that sense with an existing citizen of our country. Now, to link the Citizenship Amendment Act, which is an act passed, with a process which is NRC, which is not even started. There is not even rules or regulation. Nothing has been formulated on it yet. And I wish to state that as and when the NRC process will start, it will not start without consulting the stakeholders.
Congress leader Priyanka Gandhi lent her solidarity to protesters in the national capital. She said that both the NRC and the CAA are against the poor because they will be the most affected.
देखिए देश भर में प्रोटेस्ट हो रहे हैं ये जो कानून है CAA और NRC का ये बेसिकली गरीबों के खिलाफ है क्योंकि सबसे अफेक्टेड गरीब तक का होगा आप बताइए अगर किसी को दस्तावेज पुराने दस्तावेज निकालने पड़ेंगे दिखाने के लिए कि उनकी जमीन है कि वो पैदा कब हुए कहां हुए अगर आपकी दादी को दिखाने हो तो दिखा पाएंगी तो किस स्थिति में डाल रहे हैं देश को जिस तरह से नोटबंदी के लिए लाइन में खड़ा किया था उसी तरह से अब ये चाह रहे हैं कि इस मुद्दे पे लाइन में पूरा देश खड़ा हो कौन अफेक्ट होगा इससे जो अमीर है वो तो पासपोर्ट दिखा देगा जो गरीब है वो क्या करेगा जो डेली वेज के लेबर हैं वो क्या करेंगे जो डेली वेज के लेबर है I agree with you. I've just come to say hello. I've come. Yeah. I agree. I agree with you. But no, I understand that. I'm fully with you. And in fact, that's why I came quietly. I don't want to make a drama here. I just came for solidarity towards you. Okay, and to say we're with you and we stand with you.
And of course, the political reactions have been pouring in, with leaders across various political parties expressing their views on the situation in the country. Listen in.
भारत की संसद ने संविधान का संरक्षण भारत के नागरिकों के लिए और सशक्त किया है और संविधान के दायरे में रहकर भारत के नागरिकों का हित हमेशा प्रोटेक्टेड रहेगा. ये भारत की संसद का और बीजेपी नित एनडीए का वचन है.
जो वायलेंस करता है, पुलिस उसके खिलाफ एक्शन लेंगी. हम उसको कंडेम करते हैं. डेमोक्रेटिक वे में प्रोटेस्ट होगा तो यकीनन वो कामयाब होगा और वो लंबे रास्ते तक जाएगा. और जो लोग ऐसा करेंगे, हम उनका कंडेम करते हैं. और जो कुछ भी, जहां कहीं भी वायलेंस हुआ है, जिस जगह का नाम लिया, अब देखिए लखनऊ में एक बच्चे की जान चले गई, क्या गुजर रही होगी उसके ख़ानदान पर. बेंगलुरु में दो लोगों की जान चले गई, तो ये गलत है.
विरोध का हमारी पार्टी का तरीका थोड़ा दूसरा होता है. हमारी पार्टी के लोग ये धरना प्रदर्शन करते हैं, लेकिन तोड़फोड़ आदि में हम लोग विश्वास नहीं रखते हैं. मैं अपनी पार्टी के लोगों से ये भी अपील व अनुरोध करती हूँ कि वह देश में वर्तमान में व्याप्त इमरजेंसी जैसे दमनकारी हालातों के मद्देनज़र रखते हुए सड़कों पर कतई भी ना उतरे. वो सड़कों पर उतर कर दूसरी पार्टियों के लोगों की तरह तोड़फोड़, हिंसा आदि में के चक्कर में बिल्कुल ना पड़े.
जिस तरह से सरकार ये जनता का साथ जिस तरह से बर्ताव कर रहे हैं, जिस तरह से उनका तानाशाही तरीके से उनसे पेश आ रहे हैं, हर जगह सेक्शन 144 लागू करके रखा है, इंटरनेट काट रहे हैं, मोबाइल कनेक्शंस काट रहे हैं, तो ये तानाशाही सरकार की हम घोर विरोध करते हैं. इसलिए आज दिल्ली प्रदेश महिला कांग्रेस की तरफ से हम एक फ्लैश प्रोटेस्ट कर रहे हैं अमित शाह जी के घर के सामने. और हमारा मांग ये है कि वो हमसे मिले, हमारी बात सुने और देश के जनसाधारण की बात सुन के वो CAA कानून वापस ले.
Let's now turn our attention to what else has been making news. In Junagadh district of Gujarat, a father killed his three daughters by throwing them into a nearby well. After that, he drank poison and hanged himself. The police allege that the father took the children to the well on the pretext of giving them sweets and fruits to eat. He then committed the crime because he was unhappy with the birth of a fourth girl child. The mother was visiting her parents' home with the newborn baby girl when the tragic incident took place. Further investigation is underway by the local police.
જેના લીધે તથા આર્થિક સંકળામણમાં આવી ગયેલ હોય, જેના લીધે તેણે પોતાની ત્રણ દીકરીઓ 8, 7, અને 3 વર્ષની તેને ગામની સીમમાં લઈ દઈ અને કુવામાં નાખી દઈ મારી નાખેલ, તેમજ પોતે પણ ઝાડ સાથે ગળે ફાંસો ખાઈને આત્મહત્યા કરેલ છે. જ્યારે ચોથી દીકરીનો જે જન્મ થયો હતો અને એની પત્ની એના માવતરે હોય એ બચી ગયેલા છે. પોલીસ તપાસ ચાલુ છે.
In Tamil Nadu, two women allegedly attempted to sell a 40-day-old baby boy in Coimbatore. The two women are allegedly repeat offenders and they were out on bail, having been jailed earlier as well in an illegal child trafficking case. 27-year-old Haseena and another woman, Kalyani, were arrested in May after Namakkal police busted the child sale racket. Both these women were caught again attempting to sell a 40-day-old infant for 2 lakh rupees to an auto rickshaw driver. The cops have now traced the child's parents and are trying to find out if there were more people who were in fact involved in this trade. Those, of course, what's interesting is that how both these women were exposed. Haseena and Kalyani, in fact, demanded more money from the buyer because the infant was a boy. This led to also an argument which then turned into a scuffle. Later, bystanders informed the cops about the scuffle. In the probe by District Child Protection Unit, cops found out that the two women were running a racket to sell the infants. So this is essentially how all of this really happened and how this baby selling racket was in fact busted. Those, of course, are the visuals of the man who tried to buy the infant and the woman by the name of Haseena who tried to sell the infant. Now, interesting here to note, and that's Kalyani as well, who was the other person who was involved in this entire trade. And both these women were, in fact, have been jailed as well earlier on after being caught in a similar situation trying to sell involved in child trafficking cases. And now, once again, after coming out, they have got involved once again in trying to sell a baby here. And this is how this entire thing came to light. In Tamil Nadu, this was a deal that was struck to sell a baby, a 40-day-old baby, an infant, in fact, was being sold to an auto rickshaw driver for 2 lakh rupees. And of course, that's when both these women got busted. Moving on, in a filmy police thriller, Mumbai police have nabbed a serial offender who is a cab driver by profession. Within a month and a half of registering the FIR, the accused is charged for allegedly threatening and harassing a Mumbai-based radio jockey. The victim, who met the accused on a matrimony site, started doubting him when he asked her for her bank details. The victim then filed an FIR on the 6th of November, after which the chase began for the accused. In fact, the cops suspect that he is a serial offender and had duped several other women similarly in the past.
This is, of course, the latest case, the FIR, which was filed last month, which has led to police actually tracking this guy. But very interestingly, what sources are also telling us is that this is not the first time or possibly not the only case in which this man might have tried to dupe other women. Now, what do we know about the accused so far? Now, accused Vijay Alexander is a private cab driver and he's also married. But despite being married, if you go to the next point there, it will tell us that the Vijay was actually registered on a matrimonial site and he was actually getting in touch with women through this matrimonial site. In fact, he would get close to women on pretext of marriage. And police sources tell us that Vijay had in fact been in touch with a lot of women over the past several months because he would in fact have this premise of being open to marriage opportunities, which is why he could get in touch with a lot of these women. And he would also, according to sources, lie to these women about his job profile. He did not tell most of them that he was actually a cab driver. If you go into the next point, what we also know about is that one of the things which police suspect is that this is not his first offense, that he was blackmailing this woman. In fact, eventually he would ask a lot of the women that he was in touch with about their bank account details. Now, in this case, of course, as Santhia was mentioning, that the radio jockey actually got alarmed when he started asking about her bank account details, and that is where she withdrew, and also after she suspected that there was something wrong. But police are suspecting that he would do this with several other women as well. And once any of them actually denied giving these details to him, he would start blackmailing them either through images or any other information that he would have about them. And through this, what police sources are also saying is that he has in fact contacted at least 70 women through these matrimonial sites. And at the time when he was arrested, if we go to the next point, at the time when he was arrested, the police in fact say that he was in touch with at least 6 to 7 women. So he will, of course, this is what we know about the police, about the accused rather, so far. But of course, these are initial days of investigation where the police are trying to find out more.
So let's also now take you through how the cops pulled off this catch. Now, the accused, who is a private cab driver, didn't have the mobile number registered on his name. His location kept changing based on his rides, which posed challenges for the cops. So, of course, that is how the accused was caught. The police also went through the accused's call records. The cops noticed that the accused orders frequently from Zomato. And that is interesting in terms of how that was used to, in fact, nab and catch the accused. So that, of course, is one of the main points which the cop used to nab him. Those, of course, are the details as far as this entire case goes. And the police then found out that the accused did not pay for a particular Zomato meal that he had, in fact, ordered. The cops then pretended to call from Zomato before that particular meal that hadn't been paid, and that's and the cops then connected with him and then asked the accused to pay for the meal by giving free rides to Zomato. So that's really how the cops pulled this off. The accused then accepted the offer as well, and he showed up to pick up Zomato employees, and the accused then got arrested by Mumbai police. So that's exactly how that entire net was formed and how the accused was in fact caught by the police through this manner. And simply the one single detail that the cops found out was that he ordered frequently from Zomato, and that's how this entire web was spread and the accused nabbed. Moving on now, Maharashtra Home Minister Eknath Shinde has said that the state government will consider bringing in a law like Andhra Pradesh's Disha Act for ensuring speedy justice in cases of crime against women. Remember, Andhra Pradesh Assembly passed the Andhra Pradesh Disha Bill last week. The law mandates a verdict in cases of crime against women within 21 days and completing a probe in rape cases within 1 week. It has been named as a tribute to the veterinarian who was raped and murdered in Cyberabad recently. Those, of course, are the details as far as this, as far as Maharashtra is concerned. Maharashtra essentially now the government mulling to follow Andhra's footsteps and mulling to bring in force this similar act that is similar to the Shark, which puts in place proper, you know, timelines, especially when it comes to crime against women, because we know how so often all of these things get delayed and justice really gets delayed in several of these cases. So at this point in time, what we know is that Maharashtra is mulling bringing in a law like Andhra Pradesh's Disha Act. And those details, of course, are still in very early stages. But the fact is that it is being mulled right now. Well, in temporary relief to Sister Lucy Kalapura, in a Kerala court has granted an injunction on her expulsion from the Franciscan Clarist congregation. Remember, Sister Lucy has been one of the biggest supporters of the Kerala nun who was allegedly raped by Franco Mulakkal, the bishop from Jalandhar. Sister Lucy was expelled on August 7th by the congregation for failing to give a satisfactory explanation on her lifestyle. The next hearing by the court will be on January 1st. Well, time to slip into a quick break. We've got more lined up on the other side.